Hey, welcome to this edition of the Handy Randy Show. I have a Goodyear hat on today. You'll never know what to expect. As a matter of fact, you can expect the unexpected. Now, that's a little of a parody, though, because if you are expecting the unexpected, then the unexpected is expected. Now, chew on that for a moment, will you? Hey, Joe Buzza, the fixed operations manager for Hawes Auto Mall.
Correct.
Joe.
Randy.
Welcome to the Handy Randy Show. We've known each other for 100 years.
About.
Now, my background has always been, it's what's called aftermarket. And that is like new car dealerships, or new stuff. Aftermarket means it's, okay, after the new car stuff comes out, then the parts people and the garages get involved. That's called the aftermarket. You've spent your 100 years in new car dealers, correct?
Correct.
And that's where I first met you. As a matter of fact, I've done probably 100 new car owners, actually new owners clinics for you and other dealerships in the area, where we talk to the owners about stuff.
Correct.
And you continue that tradition at Hawes Auto Mall.
I do. And you're still doing it with me.
Yes, I am. So the purpose of that is it's really a good thing. I've run into people that they'll say, boy, why didn't anybody tell me that? Gee, my brakes don't work if I don't use my handbrake. They don't adjust. Boy, why didn't anybody tell me that?
Right.
I should use my handbrake more often because it protects my automatic transmission and the cogs and gears. Gee, why didn't anybody tell me that? And the list goes on. As a matter of fact, my van, my Town and Country van, which you're familiar with, it's got all kind of new lights on the dashboard. One of them, over on the left side, looks like a gravy boat. As a matter of fact, it's an oil lamp.
It is.
I don't think we've used oil lamps, Joe, in 100 years. Why is it an oil lamp?
They've never done away with it because people know that light. People know that light. But, you know, you was talking about those new owner clinics, Randy, and you know, me and you have done a lot of those. And we really think that we make a lot of friends with that. And we, you know, we gain a lot of loyalty and things like that. But the information you bring to the table is, you know, wonderful information, and it teaches people a lot of things about these new cars that they don't even realize. And we really believe in that, and we actually get a pretty good showing, actually, most of the time, 40, 50 people, especially when I tell them you're coming.
But wow. Well, I've got them fooled. Now, they don't come back for the second one, though, which is a good thing because I tell the same story over. Pardon me. Now, fixed operations manager, what does that mean?
Fixed operations in a dealership is actually the backside of the store. And when I say the backside of the store, in a dealership, they call it the front side of the store, which is the sales department, sales managers, finance department, the girls in the office. That's what they call the front of the store. In the backside of the store, it's the mechanics or technicians in today's world, mechanics in me and yours day, but parts department, parts personnel, body shop, the porters, the detailers, all the people that make the cog work. And they call us the fixed side of the business because it's where you can gauge what your expenses are. Everything's the same every month. The sales side of the business, of course, it's how many cars you're selling, how much you're doing.
It's a mystery.
Everything, you know, is up for grabs. So. You know, so my side of the business is the fixed asset side of the business, and pretty much on that side, I oversee all the vendors, all the spending, the insurances, most of the employees. Because it's a given, we know what that's going to do every month, month in and month out.
Now, it's named Hawes after Kevin Hawes.
Correct.
And he's one of these guys that started at the bottom of the dealership and worked his way up all the way to the ownership with a couple other fellows that are part owners, but it's called Hawes Auto Mall.
Correct.
Kevin, a local guy, has kids in the community, and you don't see him in front of the camera a lot.
No, he's a pretty shy individual. And you're right, he started actually washing cars for his uncle. And his uncle Bob actually now works for him, so it's turned 360. Owned a Chevy dealership down in Southern Ohio when Kevin was a kid. Started washing cars for him, got the itch, got the bug. Opened his own used car dealership right out of college. Went to Kent State, by the way. He's a local guy, wrestler, football player. Big Kent State guy. But opened a used car dealership, him and his buddy. Of course, both of them wanted to make $1 million each, and you couldn't do that in the used car business. So he decided to let his buddy have it. Then he got into the new car dealerships and, like you said, started at the bottom, worked his way up to general manager. That's where I ran across him. I actually went and become a fixed ops manager somewhere where he was a general manager. And eventually his aspiration was to own a dealership, and eventually he kept working at that and got an opportunity with a young lady over at Ray Thomas in Cahoga Falls and became part owner of that. And along with Chrysler wanting to downsize or right size or whatever you want to call it, 10 years ago or whatever, they decided to close that facility, open up the market, and give Kevin the opportunity out in Ravenna. And Erica Thomas decided to go have babies and move on with her life. And so Kevin moved on by himself. And as you said, he's a local guy, actually down in the Hoover area. Has his daughters are cheerleaders for Hoover. His son played baseball and stuff for Hoover. Now his son goes to Kent State. But just a great, great family. Great family man. His daughters are twins, by the way. He's got his life cut out for him now. They're both beautiful girls, seniors. He's just a down-to-earth guy, probably one of the best owners. And I've worked for a lot of different owners that own dealerships. And he's probably one of the best down-to-earth guys that you'd ever meet. But shy, not in front of the camera. And
like some of the guys are always, they're the spokesperson.
Right.
He lets some wizard.
Well, some people think he's the wizard, but he's not. He gets asked that all the time. Are you the wizard?
Hawes.
Now, correct.
That wizard is somewhere between the Wizard of Oz and the Wizard of Hogwarts School, somewhere in between there. Kind of a crazy, mixed up guy.
He's a eccentric individual, I'll say. But he really believes he's the wizard.
Oh, no.
He gets into that. I mean, he really does believe. Believe it or not, he was a customer of ours and still is, actually. Brings his car in to get repaired by us.
So we'll have to make sure that in some future show that we'll invite the wizard to be on the Handy Randy show.
You won't need to be here because he'll just do the whole show.
Beautiful, man. I love it when that happens. Now, successful dealership. Last time, as a matter of fact, I was in Ravenna, which the dealership is located right on Route 5, on the corners of 14.
59, 14, and 5. They're at Five Corners. If you know anything about Ravenna, it's a pretty major intersection there. Ravenna's a small town, I think 11,000 people, but right there at that intersection.
The last time I was there, Joe, you made the announcement to the owner's clinic that Hawes Auto Mall, for their size, was the number one dealership in Ohio. Is that correct?
Actually, in the nation. For our size dealership, we were number one in the nation and have been for about the last 8 months. And that's in car sales. The number of new cars that we put on the road for our size dealership, we do a pretty good job.
So that speaks volumes. That doesn't come by accident.
No.
That means you have a complete support. You have to have great customer service and high ratings in customer service for those things to happen. Because again, Chrysler's just not going to award that to you by happen chance.
And in a town of 11,000, you know, there's not many sales there. So.
No, so people have to come from everywhere to buy cars there.
We pull from all over the state of Ohio, and actually we've had people come in from Canada. We have people, Pennsylvania a lot. We're pretty close to the Pennsylvania border. But we get that a lot. But we pull from all over, and we have to. And in today's world, it's not like the old days when me and you were buying cars. You know, everything's internet-based, and you know, you really have to work that side of the business in today's world if you want to stay alive.
I want to talk a little bit about internet, but before we go there, we're talking to Joe Buza, operations manager at Hawes Auto Mall. You're in charge of the collision shop.
I am.
The parts department.
Yes.
Service department.
Correct.
That's a huge job, and each one of those, each department is huge to a dealership.
It's its own business.
Yeah, three individual businesses all tied into one. I want to talk a little bit about the collision business, the parts business, which is my favorite subject, and of course the service end of things. But before we go there, good news on the horizon for the folks that watch this show from Summit County, Wayne County, Stark County. They don't have to drive all the way to Ravenna if they're watching from Summit County, Stark County. They can drive down Route 30 now.
Right.
That same great service.
We just purchased a dealership in Dalton, Ohio. I was taught that it's Dalton, not Dalton.
Oh, I know. They'll kill you down there. That's the first rule is Dalton, right? The
it's
first
Dalton
thing to tell you.
And now I say it every time. So I know it's Dalton, but we've been there since we bought it August 1st, or we took it over August 1st. Been there for 47 years. Super spot, we believe. But yes, you can do business at either store. We mirror each other. All of our procedures and policies and everything we do daily is done at both stores the same way, every day, all the time. So the service you get in Ravenna, you can get in Dalton.
Dalton. No, can't say that. Right on the corners of Route 94 and 30.
Correct.
Old dealership, been there a long time. And so you're going to continue the tradition of Chrysler, Dodge,
correct,
and Dodge trucks.
No, Ram trucks. No, Ram trucks.
I was testing you on that.
But it's
all
its
these
own
years,
now.
We've known Dodge, the Dodge brothers, and the Dodge trucks. For a while there, the Dodge trucks got into the big semis. Didn't work. They kind of always then catered to the one ton and down.
Correct.
And for some reason, now it's not called Dodge anymore.
And I think it's the marketing with the Ram Tough and, you know, all the Ram stuff that has been put forward for the last several years, actually. I think that drove that to be its own franchise now, actually. And you'll notice on our signs and everything, you know, it's like the Plymouth of the old days. Now it's the Ram. And so Chrysler's good at that.
And that's the brand.
That is the brand. It's its own entity in today's world.
I have a question. I'm a little bit of a devil's advocate here, and that is I walk into the showroom, I see these battleships sitting on the showroom floor, Ram trucks, 3/4 ton. They're huge. They have 5.7 Hemi motors in them.
They do.
How do they maintain the CAFE standards that are mandated by the government on these battleship trucks?
Well, they have multi-displacement motors in today's world, which, you know, you have to keep the fuel mileage to, you know, you get a mix. So to have the Vipers and the things like that that aren't very fuel conscious, you have to have some fuel conscious vehicles. And that's the government standard. So they've done that in a lot of different ways, tolerances inside motors and the multi-displacement, you know, as you're going down the road, that 5.7 goes to a 6-cylinder and then a 4-cylinder. And, you know, you can probably get somewhere around 18, 20 miles a gallon on the highway in a pickup truck, four-wheel drive pickup truck, which is unheard of in the, you know, used to be 8-10 in our day. But with that multi-displacement, and you don't even know it, it'll do it at a light, it'll... Actually, now they even turn themselves off and restart. You don't even know it when you hit the gas pedal. Hit the brake, you stop, and it knows you came to a complete stop. It turns the car off. Then as soon as you hit the gas pedal, it starts immediately. It doesn't miss a beat. You don't
Amazing.
Know it. It's all electronic.
The technology is beyond belief on what's happened under the hood of the vehicles. In the old days, as a matter of fact, when I drive my 73 or my 1937, if that car breaks down, I could fix it. Absolutely. I can still fix it. I can see if it's got spark and gas and maybe even look at the points and condenser. That brand new 2013 vehicle, if it quits, if I can't fix it by slamming the hood, then I'm probably going to have to call you, Joe.
You're going to definitely have to call a hook. And you know, I do have to say, even though there are a lot of electronics in those vehicles, they're very dependable in today's world. You know, me and you used to, you know, write the newspaper if we hit 100,000 miles on our vehicle. I mean, that was like something you wrote the newspaper about.
Exactly.
Today's world, to get a couple 100,000 if you maintain it is nothing. And, you know, we don't see the warranty issues that we did in the past. They built a very good product. And, you know, with all the electronics and computers and all the things going on inside that car, you would think that, you know, it would be to the contrary, but it's not. It's, you know, they really do build them well. My day, when me and you got in the business, I'd do 95% warranty, 5% customer pay. In today's world, it's the opposite. You know, I do 95% customer pay and 5% warranty. They build them better.
They do.
Without a doubt.
They do. And, you know, we talk about the electronic start or the remote control start on new vehicles. That was unheard of. You could never, ever consider putting a electronic start on my 73 Lincoln Mark IV.
No.
Couldn't happen. Today, on my Town and Country van, boom, hit a button. It's 20 degrees outside. I know that thing's going to be nice and warm when I get in it after work because of the technology, the electronics and so forth. It's amazing.
It's unbelievable. And you're right. I mean, it kicks the heat on high. It kicks the defrost on for you. It turns your seat heater on, maybe your coffee cup warmer if it has it. I mean, it turns all that stuff on because it knows you remotely did it. And you know, when you come out, it's all nice and warm. You don't clean any windows.
But the technicians have to be able to fix used to just do tune-ups.
Oh, yeah.
But don't do tune-ups. Now they have to fix heated seats, radio frequency modules that there might be six or seven on the vehicle.
At least.
Speaking of that, you also oversee the collision shop there.
I do.
A modern automobile that is in a collision, you know, small, large, whatever. And I equate that not only the collision part, but take your PC at home and drop it on the floor. That happens in a collision on an automobile or truck.
Absolutely does.
We don't think about that up front, but those things can, if I know that if I drop my PC on the ground, it's probably not going to function properly after the collision. We have to remember that when we have our vehicles worked on at a collision shop, we better find a place that's able to go online and do all of the radio frequency and module repairs.
Check them all out.
Which a dealership offers.
We do, and you do have to really watch that stuff today. And after the repair, you need to go through the systems and check them all and make sure that they're functioning. And you have to have the right equipment to do that. And of course, that stuff isn't, you know, cheap. So at a dealership, you know, typically we have all that stuff at our hands. Most of it's mandated. We have to have it. We don't get a choice. You know, we're not like the guy down the road that, you know, do I buy it or don't I buy it? Chrysler sends it in and sends you the bill.
Right. And along with that, your technicians are constantly going to school.
All the time. I mean, I have, I have three or four guys in school every week probably. I have 15 guys in the service side of it, and then I have six guys in the collision side of it. And at any given time, three of them guys are out at schools. And you just have to keep that continuing education. Or you can't fix the cars in today's world. Chrysler also mandates that. Not to mention, in today's world, you need a GM certified technician, even though I'm a Chrysler dealer. You need a Ford certified technician. You need an import technician. And you have to find those guys in that mix of repair guys to be able to work on everything that's out there.
With that in mind, then when we think of Hawes Auto Mall and we need collision work done, you have Ford technicians at your dealership. You have General Motors technicians. With that, they have the scan tools that are able to do Hondas and Toyotas and Nissans. So you could take anything in the family, anything that's in the driveway, to your collision shop.
Absolutely.
To get it done. It doesn't have to be just the Chrysler brand.
Absolutely. And, you know, my philosophy is I'm a one-stop shop. Doesn't matter if you bought a Chrysler from me. Doesn't matter if you own a Chevy in your driveway. Doesn't matter if you own a Land Rover in your driveway. We want you to come to Haas for everything. So I equip myself that way. And we want to be a one-stop shop for you. There's nothing that I don't do there. Stone chips and windshields and, you know, details. And there's nothing that we don't do. Tires and, you know, exhaust systems. And, you know, you have to do everything. And you know, I want you to, when you think about cars, think about Haas and not think any further than that.
In the parts department, because I have to save some of this for the parts guys. Because I'm the parts guy.
You're the parts guy.
So, parts guys, this is your part, and that is that we have the parts that the car was born with.
Correct.
If we do have a warranty issue, that part that was on the car when it was due goes back on the car on a repair. But you mentioned customer pay. So we can give customers options too.
Absolutely.
We can say, look, okay, it's going to cost you X amount of money if we do it this way. If we opt to go to our local parts store to buy the parts, we might be able to save a little money by putting aftermarket parts on.
Correct.
So those guys in the parts department, not only do they have to know the Chrysler, Ram side of things, but they're also acquiring parts from parts stores, so they have to be able to go either or.
Correct, and we like to give you three choices. We give you factory, obviously, we're a factory dealer. Then we give you the aftermarket side. We may give you two or three choices. There's a lot of aftermarket product out there. We may give you two or three ways. I feel some are better than others. And then we give you an LKQ, which is like, kind, and quality, which may be something that was wrecked sitting in a what we called a boneyard of the days
right.
past, or a junkyard or a salvage yard. They may have a, you know, perfect part on one of those cars, so we'll give you that option also.
Beautiful. And, so again, that's why Haas Auto Mall is growing. That's why Haas Auto Mall ranks number one in the United States, and it's people like Kevin Haas and Joe Buzza, now part of the Handy Randy Show. And Joe, what I'm gonna do is bring the camera out to the dealer, both dealerships, but both in Ravenna.
I'd love it.
And what's the name of that town?
Doughton.
On the corners of Iden. Corners of 94 and Route 30, now open. You're open Monday through Saturday.
Correct.
And you can make appointments online.
You can do appointments online. You got to be in today's technology. I'm like you. I'm old school. I've got people that are younger around me that know that side of the business that handle that for me. But you have to be smartphones, texting, and you know, emailing, and all those things. And most of our systems in our stores we'll do that on the automatic. When I click the button and say your car is done, it'll send you a text if you'd like me to. It'll make a phone call for you. If however you want us to contact you, we have the ability to do that in today's world.
So now you know the face, Joe Buzza, and if you have any questions at all, and again, it's whether it's sales related or any of those things in the back end, you know Joe now, and he's always available. By contacting him, you may live in a Doughton area, and he may be at Ravenna one day, but I promise you, he'll get back to you. And now you know a little more about this great dealership that's right in our backyard, here to serve you, ranked number one in the USA. Thanks for being on the show, Joe.
Randy, it was great as always. It was great as always.
And remember, every week, right here on the Handy Randy Show, car stuff.